The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 3rd chapter, text number 17, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded in the summer of 1966 in New York.
Jasto Atmarati Devasya Atma Tripta Samanaha आत्मनैव च संतुष्ट तस्य कार्यं न विद्यते। नाउ सो फार यज्ञ ऑफरिंग सैटिस्फाइड फॉर द सैटिस्फैक्शन ऑफ द सुप्रीम लॉ एज वी आर डिस्कसिंग फॉर द लास्ट टू डेज. Now, here, Lord Sri Krishna says that for a person who is already situated in the spiritual platform and is satisfied with his own self, he hasn't got to do anything. He has surpassed the stages of offering sacrifice, worship, prayers, everything. One who is situated in self-satisfied state, just like Sukhdev Goswami, he was, as the other day, we were narrating the story of Sukhdev Goswami. He was passing on naked, 16 years old boy, young boy, and very nice feature of the body, peaceful, and he was passing naked. And the girls who were taking bath naked on the river, they saw that innocent person, so they did not cover their body. But when the father was passing, such a learned sage, old man, Vyasadeva, who is the author of all Vedic literature, is not an ordinary man. But because he was a worldly man, a householder, the girls, after seeing him, covered their body. That story the other day we have narrated before you. So, the sage of Sukhdev Goswami is atmarati, self-satisfied, doesn't care for anything of the world, he is aloof from the world. We should not imitate Sukhdev Goswami and become naked. Simply why? Because there are many so-called mendicants in India. Loiter in the street naked, and sometimes they are arrested by the police. Like, the imitation is not required. Imitation is not required. But there is a stage like that. Just like a madman, sometimes a madman, he also, wanders the street naked. So he is also compacting some thought. So, but he is a madman. But similarly, a person who is completely compact in Krishna thought, Krishna consciousness, he is also a madman according to the calculation of this world. I think there is a line in Shakespeare's literature, the lunatic, mad, and the poet or something like that, all compact in thought. So, the madman, an atmarati person, self-satisfied man, outwardly you will find there is no difference. But inwardly, oh, very vast difference. There is a story of Jadbharat, a Brahmin boy whose name was Jadbharat. He was formerly the emperor of this world. His name was Maharaj Bharat. And by his name, now India is called Bharatvarsha. Formerly, this whole planet was named as Bharatvarsha. Before that, this planet was named as Ilavati Varsha. Long, long years, millions of years before. That Jadbharat, he also lived Atmarati, self-satisfied. In the beginning of his spiritual life, he left this world at a very young age, when he was only 24 years old. He left his wife, children, and kingdom. It's not joke. An emperor with beautiful young wife, small children, and palace, he left everything. There are many instances like that. Raghunath Das Goswami, about whom we pray daily, Vande Rupa Sanatana Raghujugo, Sri Jiva Gopalako. This Raghunath Das Goswami, he was also a young man and a very rich man's son. At that time, 500 years before, his father's income was, 10 million rupees. So there are many instances in India we have got. But this Jadbharat, he left his kingdom and family and everything and went for spiritual realization, self-realization. Unfortunately, he was again in affection with a cup of beer, and he got next life. I think I have already narrated this story. While he died, he was thinking of that beer cup, and he became a beer. Jamjanga bapis manan loke tajatan de kalevaro. That is the age and the technique of death. At the time of death, whatever you are thinking, that means you are preparing your next life like that. Therefore, the whole life shall be so processed that at the same time, at the end of our life, we can at least think of Krishna. Then, sure and certain, we go back to Krishna. This practice has to be done. Because, unless we practice why you are strong and stout, and our consciousness is right, thinking. So instead of wasting time in so many things for sense gratification, if we go on concentrating on Krishna consciousness, that means we are making a solution of all the miseries of our material existence. That is the process, Krishna consciousness. Always thinking of Krishna. Therefore Krishna comes and he presents himself just like ordinary man acting. Why? Just like here in the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna is present in the battlefield of Kurukshetra. Oh, he had no necessity of presenting himself in the battlefield of Kurukshetra. But it is for us, because we are very much anxious to know where battle is going on, where fighting is going on, where detective is working, where murder is committed. All these literatures attract us very much. Stories and literatures, all these things, they attract very much. In a book shop you go, if you ask them, supply me one copy of Bhagavad Gita, he'll have to find out. But if you ask a bookseller, give me some novels, oh, he'll present so many things. Because our inclination is like that. We are always anxious to learn this mundane affair. We have no taste for spiritual upliftment. That taste we have lost. That is the stage of our present existence, forgetfulness. Oh. We do not know how our taste should be created, how our taste should be converted from material to spiritual. That we do not know. Therefore, Lord is so kind, Krishna, that He creates a battlefield for you, so that you may be anxious to know who is fighting with whom, who is fighting. That we are anxious to know, we are always very much anxious to learn stories. So all these Puranas, just this morning we are discussing, Sri Sudra Dijabandhunam Trayinat Suti Gochara. Vyasadeva is so kind that he could understand that the next generation before, I mean to say 5,000 years before, when you are thinking, you should always know that great thinker, great, I am to say, sages, we see, they are sitting in the secluded place, in a forest, not idly. They are always thinking how people should be benefited. How people should be benefited. Lokanam hitakarinam. Just like we sing daily about the Goswamis. Nana sastra vicharanai kanipano sadharma sangasthapako lokanam hitakarinam tribhuvane manno saranyakano radha krishna padarabinda bhajanandena matvalikam vande rupa sanatanam rakhujitam sri jiva gopalakam. Now just see, these gentlemen, they are, some of them were big jamindars, some of them were learned scholars, some of them were ministers in the government service, but they left everything. And at Vrindavan, they sat down, nana shastra vicharanai kanipano. Now, they are finally making research by researching whole kinds of Vedic literature, how things should be presented to the people of this age so that they can take up the matter very seriously and easily, and they can make progress. That was their vision. Not that they left home, become easygoing, and take prasadam and go on sleeping. Oh. No. They have no time to sleep. They are always thinking. Lokanam hitakarinam. How people should be benefited. As much as the Lord is very much anxious for our benefit, similarly, the devotees of the Lord, they are equally anxious for the benefit of the public. So, Lord Sri Krishna, he created. Now this Mahabharat, you have heard the name of Mahabharat. It is the history of the fighting between two parties, Kuru Pandava. So this Mahabharat was especially made, just like expert writer, they will pick up some historical facts and put it into fiction, so to create more interest. In Bengal, there is a famous writer who is compared with Scott of England, saw Bankim Chandra Chatterjee. Oh, he, all his novels are picked up from some historical fact. Historical fact. That makes the fiction very interesting. Similarly, Mahabharata, this is a history of fighting between two parties. And that was written specially, Sri Sudra Vijabandhuna Traina Suti Gochara. We are just discussing this shloka this morning. Sri Sudra Vijabandhuna. Sri means woman class. Woman and Sudra and Vijabandhu. Sudra means ordinary people, not intelligent class, ordinary people. Sudra and Vijabandhu. Vijabandhu means born in higher caste family, but their qualification is need, such person. Formally, according to Varnashram Dharma, it is not that because I am a Brahmin son, therefore I am a Brahmin, just the practice is going on now in India, caste system. Oh, that was not the system. The system was different. So, this Mahabharata was written for such persons who are claiming to be a Brahmin because he is born in the Brahmin family. But according to Shastra scripture, such persons are not called Brahmin. They are called Vijabandhu, a friend of a Brahmin. So just like I am son of a high court judge. So that does not mean I am also high court judge. I must be qualified to become a high court judge. But if I go on, that because my father is high court judge, therefore I am also high court judge. So these things are going on now in India. Because his forefather was a Brahmin, or his father was a Brahmin, and although he has no qualification of a Brahmin, he also claims to be a Brahmin. But the scripture, the Vedic scripture, that does not allow. They will call, no, you are not a Brahmin, you are Brahmin's son, that's all. We can admit so far. There is no harm admitting you that you are a son of a Brahmin, but we cannot admit you, Brahmin. That is quite reasonable. So the Mahabharata was written for such persons who are son of a Brahmin, but actually by qualification he is less than Sudra. So Mahabharata was written for them. And in the middle of Mahabharata, Bhishma Parva, this Bhagavad Gita is inserted. Practically in the battlefield of Mahabharata, this Bhagavad Gita was spoken, and it is in the surprise, in those days, television was in the heart. Television. Battlefield of Kurukshetra was television, and in the heart of Sanjay, Dhritarashtra, the father of one party, Duryodhan, and his secretary, Sanjay, was sitting in the room, and they were discussing what happened after this, just like you get television or radio message in a football ground, what is going on by sound and picture. So the same thing was being reflected in his heart, and he was in the room, he was explaining the activities of the battlefield. And this is the story like that. Sanjay Vacha, Dhritarashtra Vacha, the beginning. Dhanmakshetri Kurukshetri Samavita Jidusava Mamaka Pandavastaiva Kimakudvata Sanjaya. Now the old king and his secretary were sitting in a room, and the first question was, well, Sanjaya, what happened again? This and that. And he was speaking like that. And that was a telling. Anyway, now this Bhagavad Gita was written, was spoken to a family man, Arjuna, military man, and the whole Mahabharata is meant for Sri Shukadeva Bhagavan, the less qualified man. Just see, in those days less qualified men were meant for understanding Bhagavad Gita in half an hour. Just imagine what class of less intelligent persons were at that time. The same Bhagavad Gita, now scholars like Dr. Radha Krishna and others, so many big scholars, they are scrutinizing this study, you see they cannot understand. But this Bhagavad Gita was meant for the less intelligent class of men of that time. Just you can imagine what class of less intelligent class and women were there. It is specially written, you will see. Sri Shukadeva Bijabandhunam Trayina Sri Gotaram. Because woman class and less intelligent class and these unworthy sons of the Brahmins and Kshatriyas, they will not be able to understand the original Vedic literature. Therefore, it has been presented in a story form with historical facts so that they can understand. That was the origin. So Bhagavad Gita is a not very high class Vedic literature. It is just the entrance, ABCD of Vedic literature. ABCD, entrance. Just like matriculation examination, school leaving examination, then you entered into college and then get your become a graduate and then postgraduate. So the Bhagavad Gita is just entrance for entrance examination for spiritual education. It is written for the common man. Common man, householders, less intelligent man, woman class, like that. And originally the Ved is one. Yajur Veda. And because it was very difficult to understand Veda, Veda was spoken by Lord Himself to Brahma. So seeing, foreseeing the condition of the present age, Vyasadeva divided four Vedas, one Veda into four. The original Veda is Yajur Veda. Then he divided into Sama, Yajur, Ri, Atharva. Then again, the Vedic literatures are explained in Puranas, 18 Puranas. Then Mahabharata. Then again, he summarized all the Vedic knowledge into Vedanta Sutra. Vedanta Sutra. Summarized. Then again, the Vedanta Sutra is explained by Srimad Bhagavatam. These are the all Vedic literature. When you read this book in the preliminary, those who have got books will find all these descriptions. So, Krishna, for understanding of the common people, the highest truth of Vedic literature, the highest truth of Vedic literature is Krishna. And nothing else. It's fine. See, in the Bhagavad Gita, the Lord says, Veda is the sarvai aham eva veda. The whole purpose of Veda is to understand me. That's it. If one has understood Krishna, then he has understood all Vedic literature. He has nothing to understand anymore. He has passed all engineering. Vedaishta sarvai aham eva vedyam. Vedanta krit veda videma chaham. And the Lord says that I am the writer of Vedanta because Vyasadeva is an incarnation of Krishna for writing this literature. His name is Krishna Dvaipayana Vyas. Therefore, as incarnation, of that, Krishna wrote all this Vedic literature. So Vedanta Krit and Veda Videma Chaham, And if anyone understands Veda, then it is I only who understands Veda. Therefore, if we understand Krishna, then we understand everything. We understand Veda. Jasmin vijnate sarvameva vijnatam bhavanti. If anyone understands one, just like in arithmetic, if you understand 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, then you understand everything. Because in arithmetic or mathematics, there is nothing than these nine figures. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9, 6, you make it a multiplication subtraction or division or whatever process you have. There is nothing but 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9. Similarly, if you understand Krishna, then you understand the whole Veda. And for understanding Krishna, here is the nut spoken by Krishna himself about himself. What I am, you can go on thinking, the Swamiji said like that, the other day, Paul was speaking that somebody has informed that I have got 15 children. Now, I do not know how one can understand that I have got 15 children. I never told in this meeting, but he told me that somebody told me I have got 15 children. But this is misunderstanding. If I say, he asked me, Swamiji, how many children you have got? I told him, I have got at home 3 boys and 2 girls. And he told me that I understood that you have got 15. So that means, anyway, if you want to know about me, then you must know from me. That is authentic. That is authentic. Or from a confidential person who is in confidence of me. Similarly, if you want to know Krishna, then here is Bhagavad Gita, spoken by Krishna himself. You just try to understand and you learn Krishna. Or you learn confirmation. Suppose if you cannot understand Krishna by reading Bhagavad Gita, but hearing Bhagavad Gita, then you know that Bhagavad Gita was spoken to Arjuna, and Arjuna has admitted about his understanding in the 10th chapter. So just try to understand Arjuna. How you understand? Either you understand Krishna directly, or you understand through the authority who has spoken directly by the Lord. So there is no difficulty to understand Krishna. And if you understand Krishna, your life is perfectly ordered. When you get your life and the complete perfection of your life, that is the whole literature. So here the Lord says, jastu atmarati revasya. Atmarati, one whose focus of life is simply for self-understanding. Atmarati. Sya. Atma triptascha manava. He is simply satisfied with his self-understanding, that I am pure consciousness. My relation with Krishna is such and such. My relation with this world is temporary. My real relation with Krishna, this Krishna is permanent, and I am permanent. I am his part and parcel. This simple thing. So, one who has understood these things nicely, and he is satisfied in himself, just like Sukadeva Goswami, he didn't care for anything. Who is naked dancing or naked bathing? No, he has no care. He is going on. And he is finished. jasto atmaniteva shat atmatripta samanava atmaneva santushta. He is satisfied in himself and with Krishna. Tasya karjam abhidhyate. He has nothing to do. But he is free. Now, if you are not in that stage, then you have to perform sacrifice, as recommended in the Bhagavad Gita. Jagya Arthitan Mannasru Kayam Kama. You have to work in such a way that your work will be purified gradually and will come to this stage of Atmarupa. But if you from the very beginning you are satisfied with yourself, understand, then you have nothing to do. You have nothing to do. Just like Aradhita Jadi Hari Stabasata Tatkin. Naradhita Jadi Hari Stabasata Tatkin. Antat Bahi Jadi Hari Stabasata Tatkin. Nantat Bahi Jadi Hari Stabasata Tatkin. Stabasata Tatkin. What is the use of this nonsense penance and meditation? What is the use? There is no more use. For whom? Now, Aradhita Jadi Hari. Hari means the Supreme Personality of God. If His relationship is completely understood and one is engaged in Him, then for Him all these penances, meditation and jnana yoga, all is nonsense. Here, nonsense means He has no requisition for all these things. He has come to the highest way. Aradhita Jadi Hari. And Naradhita Jadi Hari, and after performing all these penances and jnana, yoga, meditation, ultimately and there is no understanding of Krishna, then whole thing is spoiled. Tapasata takkim, then what is the use of all this nonsense? If you have not understood the real thing. See, if you have understood the real thing, then also these things are nonsense. And if you have not understood the real thing, then these things are also nonsense. So they are two things. But that is the ultimate. But one has to come to that very point, understanding of Krishna Atmaruti. He is Paramatma, He is the Supreme Soul, and I am Atma, I am individual soul. I am part and parcel of Krishna. That relationship is eternal. And that is congenial. And that is my real happiness. We have forgotten that. We have, by chance, fallen into this material contamination. And we have made our relationship with so many material things, so that we have forgotten Krishna. Now the whole process is to revive our consciousness to Krishna. For that purpose, Krishna comes Himself, or Krishna keeps this Bhagavad Gita for you, or Krishna sends His confidential devotees to you, to canvass you, come to the point and be happy. That is the whole purpose. So Atmarati, Atmarati is self-satisfaction. You will find at Vrindavan, so many great devotees, just like this Goswami, about whom we pray daily. Now, about them, it is stated, Tattva tu namase samandala pati saning sadatu chavat. Now, these people were very astucated. Mandalapati. Mandalapati means leader of great society. So they gave up. When they joined Lord Chaitanya's movement, they gave up everything. They resigned from ministership. The Navartha was very much sorry. He was in turn that you cannot resign from this post, then the whole thing will be, and whole my plan, whole my kingdom will be lost. I cannot allow to desire. But they decided that, no, no more. Then the Nawab Sahib told him, then I put him into under internment. So they are put into jail. So anyway, they came out, saw this fact is narrated. Tatvat vurnam masesa mandalapati saneng sadat tuccha. Tuccha means insignificant. Such high post and position, they left everything. Why? Vitra dhina ganesha kau karunaya kopi natantha sito. And for doing good to the poor conditioned souls, they came to Vrindavan and become just like merely poor beggars. Their appearance became, the description is that living in a underneath a tree, one night underneath one tree, and next night another, and taking, dried, rejected bread given by the neighbors. In this way, they were living. But what was their happiness? The happiness was gopi bhavara samrita bhilahari kallo namagno sada bande rupa sanatano ravidu. They are always absorbed in thoughts of Krishna, how Krishna is having his pastimes, his activities, by thinking. So they could forget their material prosperity in exchange of thinking Krishna. So here it is said that just to Atmaritireva Sattva. So they haven't got to do anything, sacrifice or this or that, because they are absorbed in Krishna thought. So yes, Krishna says that anyone who is absorbed in such thought of his self-realization, then he hasn't got to perform this ritual, this and that and that. Now that atmarati is this Lord Chaitanya's introduction. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Krishna. There, just like we give glory, Thakur Haridas ki jai. Thakur Haridas, he was a Mahanadan during this movement. He was a Mahanadan, old man. His photograph is also there. His name was Ibrahim. And he likes to chant this Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram, Ram. He took his only business of chanting. He was chanting daily three lakh means 300,000 times. 300,000 times he was chanting. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, this Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. This is 60. By one stretch you can chant 60. Now you can make your arrangement if you want to increase, so that Thakur Haridas, he used to chant 300,000 times daily. 300,000 times daily. That's going to be. But he has no other duty. People become envious. One Brahmin Jamindar in the village, he becomes very envious. This man is Mahavidan, and yes, he is getting so much respect. I am a Brahmin, I am a Jamindar, and nobody cares for me. This way he should be giving some lesson. So he called a beautiful prostitute. Well, I shall give you such and such sum of rupees if you can, make a fall down of this man, this young man. He was a young man. Thakur Haridas was at that time about 25 years old, young man. So that prostitute That was the agreement. Oh, it is an easy thing for me. Sir, you give me such and such money, I shall get in all right. So, one day, that prostitute, very nicely dressed, and at midnight, and when he was chanting, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, and the prostitute sat down before him, and the Thakur said, why you have come? He disclosed his intention that you are such a nice, strong man, so I have come to embrace you. Oh, very good. Very good. You sit down. You sit down, let me finish. Let me finish my chanting, Hare Krishna, because I have got a vow for chanting and so many, so it is now almost finished. As soon as finished, he shall enjoy. Very good. He sit down. So, by chanting, 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 it becomes morning. Now that prostitute become restless. I'm very sorry because I could not finish my chanting. Therefore, we could not enjoy life. All right, you come this evening, this night. You can enjoy. So, next also night, she came in the same way. And the same business chanting. And he said, let me finish, then I said this. Then in the 3 days, after 3 days, the prostitute became wonderful and she fell down on his feet. Sir, this is my intention. I was instructed by this man. So please excuse me and please save me from this nonsense business. Then Kapuhudas replied, yes. I could understand your intention and who has sent you. I knew everything. But because you have come to my shelter, I stayed here for 3 days just to convert you. Otherwise, I would have gone the very same night from this place. Hey, you have come to your senses. Now, give up this nonsense business. Sit down here. And you also chant, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna. I am going from this. So that prostitute became a great devotee. He also. But this is a touchstone. Touchstone. So this is called Atmarati. Atmarati. If this movement is spread, then people will be self-satisfied. There will be no more hankering for any artificial thing. As soon as she goes on realizing the transcendental nature of Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, he will feel himself fully satisfied. Nothing can enchant him. Nothing can drag him from this platform. And for him, there is nothing to do. So that is the state. That is a stage described by Lord Krishna, that if somebody comes to this stage of life, he hasn't got to do anything of religious rituals, this or that, meditation or reading or nothing. Naiva tasya kritena artha na akritena kachana natasya sarvabhuteshu kaschid artha bhupasraya. If somebody comes to that stage of life, atmanandi, self-satisfaction, then his activities have also no reaction. Just like this Thakur Haridas. Thakur Haridas was a man in renounced order of life. Now, for him, there is injunction that those who are in a renounced order of life, they should not sit down in a secluded place with women. Why a renounced order of man? It is the Shastra injunction is that, so far Vedic literatures are concerned, they are very much strict about association three associations of man and woman. They are very much different. They have compared woman as fire and man as the a pot of butter. So, and according to strict Vedic principle, except one's own wife, nobody sit down in a private place with woman. Even if she happens to be a mother, even if she happens to be a daughter, even if she happens to be a sister. So much restriction is there. Matra sastra dhitrava nam yukta sanevaset. Either she is your mother, either she is your daughter, either she is your sister. Don't sit down in a secluded place. Hello, sit on. So such a picture is there. Now, Haridas Thakur, at dead of night, a woman came before him and she was sitting, she was chanting. So according to this restriction or injunction, she has committed wrong. No, he has not committed. Because he was trying for her benefit. He was sitting there not with the purpose of sense gratification. He was sitting with that woman with the purpose of converting him to for self-realization. He had no other intention. His only intention was, well, this poor creature has come to me. Never mind whatever her intention is. And if I am elevated, if I have anything relationship with my Supreme Lord, I must do something good to this poor creature so that his life also may become successful. That was his intention. He had no other intention. Therefore, naiva tasya kritena anartha. Therefore, for him, there is no restriction. There is no restriction. And na kritena yaha kaschana. And neither he has got any obligation that he has to do this or that. Neither by doing he has got any reaction, or neither by not doing he has to pay something, default something like that. Natasya sarvabhuteshu kasci artha bapasaya, and he has no relation with anybody to take anything from them. Now so far this self-satisfaction stage is concerned, Sukadeva Goswami is the ideal person. He was living naked, and early in the morning he would stand up in any householder's door, because in India still, I think here also the system is there, those who have got private cows, they milk the cow early in the morning. Early in the morning, if the cow is milked, it gives the proper quantity of milk. That is the system. before sunrise. So, Sukadeva Goswami, and the whole day's business was that he would go to a householder, because in India still the system is a householder keeps at least, in the village, at least 10 to 12 cows. But he hasn't got to pay anything for keeping this. The cows go to the pasturing ground, and in the evening comes back, and some grass, dry grass, which is a byproduct of the grain, then he offered to her, and instead, in place, she offers milk. So milk in the village is still, and it is available very easily, without any expenses. Now, Sukadeva Goswami, because his whole day's business was just to stand before a householder's door, because every household is milking, and people know that this Swamiji or this sage has come to take some milk. Oh, Baba, whatever you want to take. So what? say, 1 pound, or less than 1 pound, drinks and goes out. The whole day was finished business. So Sukhdev Goswami was doing like that. He wouldn't go anywhere. And he simply, all in the morning, he would stand before a householder's door and take little milk, and the whole day he would travel naked. He has recommended that why your ancestors, those who are in the renowned sort of land, those who have left the world simply for self-spiritual realization. So Sukhdev Goswami advises that if you have actually left home for spiritual realization, then you haven't got any problem for maintaining your life. There is no problem. So he recommends, Chirani Kingna Patisanti. Well, I am naked, suppose you do not wish to run on as naked, you require some cloth. All right, find out some cloth in the street. There are so many cloths thrown in the street. So you can pick up one of them. So your cloth problem is there. So, Chirani Kingna Patisanti. Visanti Viksam Nainhamti Anghirpa. Anghirpa means trees. They have got fruits. So you can ask a tree, apple tree, to give you some apples to eat. So your clothing and eating problem is solved. Or then your shelter, Buddha Guhakim. Oh, you find out some cave, a very nice place. So the house problem is solved. Then water, there are many rivers, there is no water problem. So he has recommended like that. Actually, in India, still there are persons who do not care for anything of the world. They are atmarati, they are self-satisfied, doesn't care for anything. So for such persons, there is no need of doing any yoga or purifying their activities or so many things as recommended by the Lord. The Lord says, they have nothing to do. Tatma asakta satatam karjam karma samachara asakta jyacharam karma param apnoti puru. Now, what is this meaning of this atmarati? The meaning of atmarati is that one has to be situated in full spiritual consciousness and aloof from material engagement. That is the common sense. So, the same thing can be practiced by ourselves. Of course, we may find difficulty, we may think, how it is possible to become like Sukhdev Goswami? No, it is not possible. The real fact is Krishna is explaining here that, that don't be attached to your result of the activity. Just become free. Now, for maintenance of your body, you have to do something. That's all right. But you don't be attached to that work. You are simply to, because you have got this body, you have to maintain it so that the body and soul can be maintained and you have to perform this spiritual realization. Just to keep the body nicely, not neglecting the body, but become detached from the bodily attachment. You just try to Juktahara, but to take food is not forbidden. But you have to take food only just to maintain your body, not for and to say taste of your palate or stomach. That should be practiced. You should live, you should eat to live. You should not live to eat. That should be your life's principle. Tasmād sakta, tasmād asakta satatam, asakta. Don't be attached. Karjan karma samasa. Do your duty, as you are duty bound, but don't be attached to that. What? Because you should always know that your real work is self-realization. Asakta jhataran karma param apnoti purusa. And if you practice like that, then the same perfection of life will attain. Don't be attached to your work. Don't be attached, unattached. Nirbandhe Krishna sambandhe jitta, jitta vairagamuccha. Anasaktas vishan zikharam upujana. The same advice is given in several places that work, but do not work with attachment. Just to make the best use of a bad bond, that's all. Go on working like that. Tasmad asakta satatam kajam karma samachara asakta jhyacharam karma param apnoti purusa. And if you continue your work unattached like that, then the result will be that you will also reach that perfectional stage of life, as it is the shanti. Karmana iva hi saṃsiddhīṃ āśrito janakādaya loka saṃghāma eva api saṃpatyam kartum asti. So you haven't got to give up your work, your duty. Yes. You go on doing your duty, but make your point that my life's main business is self-realization. You give more importance to that point of life, not to the point of that I shall earn more and enjoy life. No, that should be not. That is called non-attachment. So if we go on working in non-attachment and culture our self-realization, then gradually we shall come to the perfectional point. Thank you very much. Now if there is any question.